my milk goes completely cracked. I just took away the bottle. I have been weaned officially for 2 months, and I have been telling you that I was going to share exactly how I did it. Now, this video has the craziest, longest title, How I Weaned My Milk Thirsty 24/7 Nursing Co-Sleeping Baby. I had to write it down because that was our situation, you guys. My baby got to the point that it was 24/7, constantly pulling at my shirt, embarrassing me. Just like always wanted to nurse. It got to the point that it was just never enough. And I reached the same point with my first son when I weaned him at 21 months. That video is lingering around YouTube too. The trick to stop weaning your toddler. I shared that with my Band-Aids, my Band-Aid trick. But this time the Band-Aids did not work with Luki. So I had to make a whole new video for you guys. This is a 2-week process. So I'm going to share with you exactly how I did, and hopefully this can help some of you moms in my exact situation. Now, I gave it that crazy title and talked about being a co-sleeping, because chances are if you're nursing your baby after 20 months, you are most likely a co-sleeper just like us. Most people that nurse for longer periods are co-sleepers. And so I wanted this to be specific because it is a little harder if your baby's right next to you to keep them distracted off the boob. So I'm going to share with you exactly how I did this. Here's my tips and tricks. Go get a pen and paper, write down these notes. This is going to help you guys. First thing, in my desperation, I went searching on the internet, just like you guys who probably stumbled across this video. And I came across a few helpful resources. One of them was a video by Amanda Muse, who she posted her kind of like just what they did to wean their co-sleeping baby. And I took some of her tips, and that's what we did. She went on, and maybe I'll put a link to her video too, on the theories of a doctor who shared like exactly like a routine, like how to wean your baby. So I kind of gathered bits and tips from her video and then kind of like made it my own. So this is what we did. For the first week, you're going to bring down your 24/7 nursing baby down to just 2 times a day. That's it. You can pick whether it's morning and night, nap time and bedtime, whatever you want, but only 2 times a day. You're gonna cut that buffet right out. And the way that you do that is simply by saying no. No, but then quickly distracting. And I also have other videos on that on my weaning process. So they're gonna pull on your shirt as normal or want a nurse, and you just say, no, 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 no nursing. And you guys, this is gonna require some effort. This is why a lot of people, it takes so long, because it does take work. And you're like, a lot of people aren't willing to put in the work. I was there too, because at this point, when your baby starts crying, wanting the milk, boom, you get up, go outside, start showing him the leaves, the birds, the trees, like distraction city. Go and be like, oh, go to the fridge. Oh, do you want this? Do you want a drink? Do you want water? Offer other things, but you got to get up and get moving and start distracting. So that's how you're going to get it down to 2 times a day. That is it. Okay, for me, I did mornings, because that was my favorite time, mornings and evening. That was it. I would put him to bed. So once you do that for a week, you're going to do that to regulate your boobs so that you're not going to be super engorged, and your boobs are already going to be used to only nursing twice a week. Remember, your boobs are only going to produce what you're asking it to produce. If you need to do that for 2 weeks, you guys, you can do this process for 2 weeks. If you feel it takes you a little longer, I was ready and done to start weaning. So I did this the first week. Now when it comes to bedtime, chances are if you got a co-sleeper, they're waking up all throughout the night to nurse. We cut that, we nipped it in the butt. So this is what I did, and this is where Amanda's video came in handy. So he got his little bear, and I would nurse him to bed and put him to bed. If he wakes up before midnight, I would nurse him again, but anytime after midnight, no more nursing. Okay, so this is still in that first week. After midnight, no more nursing. Our kids are waking up because they're just used to the comfort. Clearly, they do not need the nutrition. They're just doing this for comfort. So you're nipping that comfort right in the butt. Right when they wake up, you give them their bear. You offer them water. I would have a sippy cup, no milk, nothing. Just you want water. Eventually, the kid is not going to want to wake up for water anymore. And that, you guys, only took me like 2 or 3 days. And that's it. My baby slept through the night. No waking up at his normal 2 a.m. wake up to nurse. It went away after just practicing this for 2-3 days. So he would wake up wanting to nurse, and I would just say, no, no, I'd put a pillow on me. I would get up out of the bed, which, you know, that requires a lot of work. Get up and just like, shh, shh, shh. But here's the thing. I only did that the first night. You don't want to create another like bad habit where now you have to like rock them or whatever. So I would just keep him in bed. Like maybe I would sit up with him or do something, but I would just keep him, pat him on the back, comfort him, just say, shh, 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 go back to bed. And eventually he would. And it only took a few nights where that's it. He slept straight through the night. So no more nursing after midnight. So week two, that's it, guys. You went a whole week with only nursing twice a week. You stopped nursing after midnight. Your baby is now sleeping through the night. And now it's time to pull the plug completely. No more nursing. Now this is up to you guys. I tried a few things throughout my process. And honestly, do whatever works for you. So the first few days, I would just put milk in a bottle. And when he wanted comfort, I would give him the bottle. He actually was so fascinated and thought it was just so cool to drink from a bottle because he hadn't drank from a bottle. And then I posted it on Instagram and a few people were like, oh, but aren't you starting another habit? You're gonna have to wean him from the bottle. And so I'm like, but he just kind of does it to think he's cool, or like he, I don't think he like really wants it, but just in case, I took their advice and I decided not to give him a bottle. But if you want to do that, you could try. At this point, it's like whatever works for you. So I did try a bottle and it worked. Like it would calm him down. He'd ask me for milk and I'd say, no, 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 you want leche in a bottle? And boom, I would just replace that. So I would ask him if he wanted water. I didn't do juice, just like either water or almond milk, and I would give it to him. So for the first few days, he would just walk around with his little bottle. And then like on the third day, I just took away the bottle. Took away the bottle from him. And he, I don't know you guys, I just umped, I like raised up my snuggles, my hug, my lovey-lovey with him. And somehow he just managed to like, that's it. After the fourth day, and this is like miraculous, you guys. But I know that it was that first week of like, the weaning and all that, like just taking it away only twice a day, teaching him the law of distraction that got him to this point, because I gave him the bottle a few times and then I would give him a sippy cup with like water. And I bought, so then I went and bought him a sippy cup, and that was like his, like something new. I had other ones, but I wanted him to feel like it was new and special. So he just had his sippy cup and that was it. So the hardest thing for you guys, the challenges is going to be the bedtime, the nap time. How do you put them to sleep? And I shared this in some of my weaning diaries, which I'll also link below if you want to watch them all and just get ideas. But you guys, the first few nights, Lord forgive me, he has already, but I would just scare my son to sleep. He'd be crying, fighting. At this point, he stopped pulling on my shirt. He wasn't asking, but he just wouldn't fall asleep. And so I'd be like, oh, look, shh. Come here, come here. And he would just get in my arms, and then fall asleep. You guys, I'm sorry, but it worked. I don't think he's traumatized. Now he sleeps in his own bed, which is another video I have to make. My kids are out of our bed, which is so amazing. I never thought that it would happen, but he sleeps in his bed. He's fine. It's my four-year-old that's more scared than he is. So you guys, that's what I would do. I would just be like, oh, what are you? Oh, I hear something. Come here, come here. And he would crunch into my chest and just fall asleep peacefully. I promise you, that's what I would do. I would also read stories with a monotone whisper in his ear. Tell him a big story like this, and I would tell him, yeah, and Superman went here, and he was flying, and then could keep this tone right in his ear, and he would fall asleep. It takes some effort. You may be in the bed for like 30, sometimes an hour, 30 minutes to an hour, but eventually, guys, after that week, you will be home clear. You'll be in the home front. No more nursing. So that's how I did it, guys. This is a long video if you need to rewind and listen to some stuff, but only in 2 weeks I did this, you guys. And I promise you that my son, I would have never seen the day he was milk thirsty. So that's it. It takes more.